What's good, everybody? How y'all doing? Y'all doing all right? I hope you're having a shit one. We got some old Bill Burr. Bill Burr, no means no. Paper Tiger 2019. Let's get into it, man.
No,
yeah.
No, stop it. What are you doing? Stop. You're being so bad. Stop it. No. Yeah, that's not a fucking no. That means I want to do it, but I'm afraid you're going to judge me, so I'm just going to make it look like it was your idea so you don't figure out that I've already performed this act with 40 other fucking people. Right? But then you go to court and you get a bad read and there's some guy reading it. Your Honor, she said no. Stop it. What are you doing? You're being so bad. Yeah, and you're just sitting there like, she didn't fucking say it like that. She didn't say it like that. Yeah. So now everybody's just like scared shitless. You know? Because I guess if women ran the world, there'd be no war. Evidently, there'd be no due process either. So you just gotta sit there going, ha, ha.
Right?
Just out of nowhere, last couple years. I'm a male feminist.
Out of nowhere.
No, you haven't. You haven't. This shit came out and you're fucking scared. You did something. You grabbed some fucking titties. What the fuck did you do that you have to overcorrect that fucking heart? What kind of a man who still has his balls is walking around saying that he's a male feminist? I'm a male feminist. I can totally see the way you see the fucking world. It's impossible as a man who was raised right. You being a feminist, you can't do it. You're a man. Look, you can agree with it. You can empathize, sympathy. You can do all of that shit, but you can't be it any more than I can stand there and just be like, I'm a Black Panther. Fight the power. And then I walk out the door, a blue-eyed white dude, and I get to live that fucking life, right? I don't know, ladies. I don't buy it. Maybe you do. I don't. Anytime you hear a guy say I'm a male feminist, I always just think that is the most pathetic, limp dick way ever to try and get some pussy, right? Like, that is literally the fucking game you had when you were on a first date when you were 16, you all nervous, and your whole game plan was just agree with her, maybe she'll touch it. I'm glad that I'm fucking, you know, married now. I don't gotta fucking deal with any of that shit. You know? Younger guys, I don't know. How do you deal with it? Like, you know what was really fucked up in all of this now? Is what about women who like it rough? Right? That doesn't happen here in the jolly old England. Right? Not at all. Everybody gets all dead silent, big fucking elephant in the fucking room. Right? Yeah. How the fuck do you. What's that? Ask for consent? Doesn't that take the mood? Well, Jesus, that kind of took it in a weird way.
Somebody from the crowd, ask for consent.
Dude, whatever the fuck I was saying, however you heard it, that's not what the fuck I'm saying, right? You know, I really listened to this Me Too movement. I think I'm, for the first time in my life, I'm going to ask for consent. I'm really going to do it this time. I've been feeling. This is why you can't judge comedians. Do you understand this? Do you understand what the fuck I was saying and how this fucking jackass just heard it?
Oh, shit.
The second it comes out of my mouth, it's not what I said anymore. It goes into your fucking ear hole and gets cut with your whole fucking childhood. Oh, this is what he means. Sir, if I could get along with my point, if you wouldn't mind that.
Oh my God.
That's gotta be weird. I remember when I was a single man a long time ago, a lot of hair ago, right? Still wasn't a good look, but I was single. I was out there taking some at bats. I remember that shit. You meet a woman when it started going down that road, like you knew you were going to hook up. What you try to do, you try to get a jump on it, right? You try to figure out what they liked in the bedroom because you wanted to satisfy them, because there's nothing worse than if you don't satisfy them. And you know they're going to tell all their friends, and then you got to fucking move, and now there's social media, you got a fucking nickname. It's a nightmare. So you just try to, you know, you try to do, you know, a little fucking intelligence. You know, you'd be sitting there hanging out, just being like, yeah, so, you know, what are you into? What do you like to do, right? One night I asked this woman that, she set her drink down, she looked me right in the eye, she's like, I like to get fucked.
Oh my God.
And I knew what she meant. I was like, all right, this is going to be one of these. Okay.
Nah, you got to watch those, man. You gotta watch those. They got something. Okay, they got something. Oh my God.
Yeah.
This, you know, dude, bro.
About sexual assault?
What? He did not just say that.
What's hilarious about it is how women are acting like that is a uniquely female experience. You know what's funny? I actually, to the letter of the fucking law, within the last 2.5 years, got sexually assaulted in this business by a woman.
Wow.
Yeah. And this is my story.
This guy here, man. Oh my God.
I feel like I can tell my truth and be brave tonight and share this with you. It's 100% true fucking story. I was doing stand-up. I was doing a private gig. All right? Private gigs are the fucking worst. You do a public gig, anybody can show up. It broadens what you can talk about, right? You do a private gig, it's like everybody grew up on the same fucking streets. All your jokes gotta go right down fucking Main Street or you're bombing. So all you do is listen to the first comic to hear what's working and what isn't. You just listen to him as he's up there struggling, going, okay, they like bread. Talk about bread. Get all the bread you can. Don't make fun of the troops. Stay away from the troops, right? So that's what we're doing, right? And the host gets him going, and then he brings up the first act. Okay, she goes on stage. She's not really a comedian, more of a personality. She does her bullshit or whatever. And I'm standing there looking at my jokes, figuring out what I'm doing. She wraps it up. He goes on stage. She goes to get off. I'm thinking, okay, I'm next. I'm looking at my stuff. And she just walks right by me and just fucking, boom, just flicked me right in the head of my dick and kept walking.
No way.
Like it was nothing. Just fucking pow. And just kept. I couldn't fucking believe it.
Why would she do that?
I know what you're thinking. You're like, oh, is this a friend of yours? Was she flirting with you? Was this a joke? You know what it was? I swear to God, it was like a bully vibe. Like she was trying to get in my head. Like, there you go, you little red dick. Follow that. Dude, my first thought as I saw her walking away, I just wanted to punch her in the back of the head as hard as humanly possible. Like, literally make her leave her shoes.
God damn. Situation. Oh my God. Look, if y'all enjoyed the reaction, look, stop it. All right, before we get, the video is not over, by the way. The video is not over. At the end of this video, there will be a skit of mine called "What If Gay People Were Heterophobic?" That's what it's called. Watch the video. If you like comedy, you like laughing, watch the video at the end of this video. It's gonna play as soon as this is over, okay? So let me know what you think about it, because I'm a comedian myself. I do skits, and this is what that is. So enjoy. Now look, I just won this yardstick of Twix, my boy. Bro, what the fuck? Where are you going? You don't want no Twix? Bitch, I don't take shit from straight people like you. Your heterosexual ass.
I should call my niggas right now to come jump your dumb ass and shove that fucking Twix bar right up your fucking asshole, nigga. See how you like that shit. You might like that shit. You might love that shit. You should try it sometime. Heterosexual ass nigga. You must really be what you eat, huh? Pussy ass. I'm just trying to see if you want some Twix, my nigga. Like, who don't like Twix? Maybe if you get you some dick in your life, you wouldn't be so goddamn ugly. Bro, it's not even like that, man. I have a friend that's bi. You can talk to him. He seemed pretty cool. Like, oh, no. It ain't enough to have a friend that's gay. You gotta be gay too, bitch. Bro, look, man. I don't wanna be gay. Like, that's just not in my DNA, my nigga. Like, I'm not wired that way. Nigga, I'll kill people like you. The fuck you just say to me? You're not wired like that. What the fuck that supposed to mean, huh? I'll wire your ass like that, bro. I'll show you what this dick talking about, nigga. You better start sucking some dick around here, bitch. Don't let me catch you around here again being straight, nigga. You better turn gay in this bitch. The fuck? Oh, puss ass, nigga.